So today we are at Serena Satrang Art Gallery. As you can see behind me and right beside me are amazing art pieces that represent the cultural and ancient tradition of Azulejo, that was an art form in Portugal. So what is Azulejo? Where did it all begin from? Where did the Portuguese voyagers take all the inspiration and put it on art? Let's see this exhibition today at Serena Satrang Art Exhibition. His Excellency João Paulo Sabito, Ambassador to Portugal, told us about the importance of Azulejos. His Excellency, please tell us a bit about this exhibition.
No, this exhibition depicts a kind of art that were developed in Portugal, but who has a lot of, in first place, Arabic influence, some European influences, but after, throughout, as it spread throughout the world, received influences from other countries, mostly also from Asia. So we can see some similarities even with the Pakistani ceramics, with Multan, because it, through the centuries, received many of these contributes. And so I think it's not only a Portuguese exhibition, although the name says Portuguese tiles, but I think it's a collective for many countries around the world, many different cultures, civilizations. That is a pride for us.
When I look at all these art pieces, I see a lot of inspiration. Basically a voyager who took it all in and he went from country to country and took the inspiration and, you know, painted it all on a tile. Do you think it's like that?
Yes, I think so. Because I think it was also a way to connect different regions in the world and several centuries ago, like in 17th century. For example, they are very interesting Brazilian tiles from the 17th, 18th century depicting Chinese characters. So because the inspiration was received from China, so the characters, they were Chinese and they are in Brazil. And that time it was very difficult, the connections to the well.
So it's basically a global exhibition, you can say, because it sort of reflects each and every country.
Yes, it's a global, it reflects maybe the first globalization in the 16th century, where several different countries start being connected, and also through art. And this is one of the forms of art that symbolizing that connection.
Thank you so much. The exhibition was organized by Madam Gloria Sabito, wife of His Excellency João Paulo Sabito. Miss Gloria has organized today single-handedly this entire exhibition, and I think it's a great achievement. So Miss Gloria, please tell us a bit about this exhibition.
Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. This exhibition has been displayed in several countries, and its aim basically promote and inform about the art of tiles in Portugal. Specifically in this case, I found the exhibition at the embassy. She was in a storage room. I just got the frames and I asked the cooperation of the Serena to display it here. So it will stay here for...
So you have this, all this information, all this great art content in your embassy?
Yes, yes, because this is posters. I just framed them, okay? But these are posters, normal posters. But the azulejos behind, the art behind, we have our countries full of this in the churches.
And what I love about this is that there's a bit of description with every azulejo.
Yes, and it's a description of every poster in English. And it also gives you an idea of the influences, because it has lots of influences from all around the world. We start with the Moorish art, and then the Portuguese were also in the discovery, so we got around the world. So we mix art from everywhere.
inspiration from each and every country.
Yeah, you can see lots of tiles very similar to Mughal art. You can also see something from your Multan ceramics that I love. I love the Multan ceramics. I hope to go to Multan. I did not have time yet. But I mean, it's an encounter of cultures, I will say. And it's explained in English, and it goes from the beginning, the 16th century, until now, because now we have the tiles displayed at the metro, subway stations, and so it's nice if you go one by one.
We have with us the ambassador of Swiss, Mr. Mark, and Mr. Mark, please tell us about this exhibition.
Well, it's a discovery for me. I have heard about the Azulejo, I think, a couple of years ago. And I had a chance to go to Lisbon in Portugal and to see that beautiful tiles in blue. So yeah, great pleasure to rediscover that, this style here in Islamabad. And also I think it's a chance for the people of Islamabad, the Pakistani, to discover this wonderful art that is very old, actually, more than 400 years, I think.
Also, if you've studied some of the art that it's around here, you'll see a lot of inspiration from different countries, you know. It's not only represent Portugal, but as I was talking to the ambassador before, that it represents Chinese culture as well, Pakistani culture as well, you know, somewhere in West and East, you know. So what do you have to say about that?
Yeah, because the Portuguese were traveling a lot. They had a lot of people, businessmen and people traveling on the boats in Asia, Far Asia. So I think that's the reason why when they came back, they took part of the culture they had discovered.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. The thing is, I was wondering if I can call the embassy and... Mr. Balani, Aziz Balani, and today he's here to promote cultural diplomacy, and he is the man behind all of this amazing prospects and projects that are happening in Pakistan. So Mr. Balani, please tell us a bit about this exhibition.
When the ambassador spoke to me about promoting their tile work, I was wondering that what sort of tile work, and he said it's Azulejo. So then I had to Google, and I was quite inspired with what he was saying. And when I looked at it, it was the inspiration of King Manuel the First in 1498, and he got inspired from Moorish architecture. And then I said, why can't we promote it? And because our whole objective is to promote first our Pakistani art and artisans, and then have a cross relationship with other countries so that we build bridges and let the
cultural democracy in true sense,
because if we promote them, they're going to promote us in their own country. This is how we promote our real culture in their country. So that was the whole objective, and I think the turnout has been amazing. And look at the quality of the artwork they have produced.
And I love the fact that there is a bit of description with each and every art piece, so that people who are not familiar with this art style can come and study about it. And we would really request all the art and architecture students, and even those who are not into art, to please come and look at this exhibition.
Absolutely, I fully agree with you, because everything is given there. They just need to spend half an hour and knowing a great cultural value of Portugal and the Western world.
So from tourism to sport diplomacy and now cultural diplomacy, what do we have next in line, sir?
Very soon there will be another event of cultural diplomacy, where we are, through cultural diplomacy, we are trying to collect charity for a good cause, for children's heart surgery. And we are doing it with Spanish embassy and the Spanish ambassador. All are lined up, and inshallah it's going to happen on 13th.
This time it's about health, this time.
Well, our focus has always been either health or education, because these are the two root causes for poverty. And this is one way of alleviating the poverty. If you focus on, in our humble way we do it, it's not a great thing, but at least our focus has always been on education and health.
Ms. Amna Malik, who is the president and founder of Co-Peer organization, and as usual she's always there to support cultural diplomacy and art diplomacy, and right now we have her with us. So ma'am, tell us about the exhibition.
Thank you very much. This is, I believe, one of a very known craft and ceramic of Portuguese ethnic history, and it comes from many years back, and it's the inspiration of the Moro architecture. So I believe that this is something which is very interesting, because this shows the similar traditions and culture which is quite common over here. And if you look at the designs,
The designs are quite similar.
Yeah, they are quite similar, and I believe, because you know, I also own one of the architecture company, so I'm very much interested to introduce some of the designs over here in one of our architectural projects. And I would like to give the message that this is not only something like a cultural exchange and a, you know, something, but it is also something which can be bring to Pakistan. And as I'm also representing the Pakistan Portugal Business Forum, so I would like that very soon we should arrange some B2B meeting of the businessmen who are interested to bring such kind of architecture, because this is something unique and people.
I think there should be an exchange between the Pakistani artisans and the Portuguese artisans, and then they can have like a B2B and they can find the market globally.
I think so. This is a very good opportunity, and it's always good to have the exchange of ideas. It's always good to have the exchange of ideas, and this is something I think I give the credit to the management of Serena, and always fire is always there is something related to diplomacy. So this is something which is going to be something very good to promote the relations.
So as you can see, this painting, you know, I think this looks more like a Christian painting, and as you can see, Our Lady of Carmel. So they have biblical paintings as well, and then they have motifs, which are Pakistaniyon ke motifs zyada hote hain, because we cannot make paintings. So I think this is very similar with Portugal.
Yes, there is no doubt about it, and I believe that this is something which is unique. And if you look at these architecture, and if you move a little bit ahead, you can see these motifs. These motifs can easily be utilized, and especially because we are also designing higher luxurious houses. So there people would like to have one feature wall embedded with such kind of, you know, items. So I believe this is something very nice. And I also would like to suggest that if we can use it in furniture, so this will look really nice. So I believe somebody from Pakistan or either us will get this
opportunity.
Yeah. So we would like to.
Viewers, you have free advice from Ms. Amna Malik to use this opportunity to get the tiles, get them engraved in the furniture, that, like you said, and I think it will make a beautiful piece of furniture. Thank you so much, Ms. Amna Malik, for being with us. Thank you.
Thank you very much.